Today we're going to talk about how to install an A4988 and a DRV8825 on the Big Tree Tech SKR version 1.4. Now, a couple of things you might want to consider. This is how the board comes default with its jumpers. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to show you how to set the jumpers correctly for this board. So I'm going to pop off these jumpers. Now the current configuration that they actually have for these jumpers are for the UART type connections in the row that they're in. So as you can see right below, it's red below. That's not the configuration that this is actually going to be. So we actually need to move the jumpers to the second row. So it's going to be half red and half black. And I'm placing these on MS0 set of pins, MS1 set of pins, MS2 set of pins, and then the reset pin according to the directions. Now the directions can be found on Big Tree Tech's GitHub website. I'll leave a link in the description so you can find those. But that's the first set of pins. Now let's do the other set real quick here. And we're going to do MS0, MS1, MS2, and then reset. So I'm going to talk about the A4988 in just a second. We have cooling fins that we're going to place on top of here. This will allow it to cool the actual chip down while it's stepping. Now I also recommend, but you don't need in this case, a cooling fan. And there are four different cooling fans on the board. You have this one here and this one here, which are direct power. This one is actually controllable, so we're going to skip this one for now. And this one may not be controllable. I'm unsure at the moment. But what I'm going to first show you how to do is place these on here real quick. So what you're going to do is you're going to peel off the sticker and you're going to place the cooling fins on top of the board. So it's going to be placed right over the chip, which is this dark patch in the center. And we're going to do the same for this board. This one I already have the sticker off, so I'm just going to stick it on. And that'll wick away the heat that's generated. Here's a close-up of the A4988. And I'm going to point out one or two things that will be obvious to you a little bit later in the video. First of all, we have our trim pod right over here. This is used to adjust the calibration of current running through your stepper driver. Initially, they're probably calibrated pretty good, so you may not need to change them. But the other things I want to point out on the board so you can actually plug these in is the enable pin over here. And then we have a direction pin and a ground pin. This way we can connect it correctly without causing any damage. On the DRV8825, we have a couple of things that I need to point out on the board. Obviously, we have our cooling fins, which now you know where they're placed. But we also have our trim pod right here. This can be used to adjust the current on your board so that you can dial it in to the correct calibration. On the underside of the DRV8825, you can see that the enable pin being EN over here is our enable pin. Now keep in mind, that's how we're going to use it to connect it to our board, so we're going to line up that pin. On the other side, we do have in the upper right hand corner the direction pin that you can see over here. That's also a great way to figure out where you're going to connect, as well as the ground pin right over here. This is the underside of the SKR version 1.4. And one thing I need to point out here is when we're looking for the enable pin, you can see it right here, right next to the diag pins above. The same goes for the other ones that are right here, 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 and here. Okay, now that we know where to connect these based on the enable pin, and we know that the enable pin from the previous portion just before this, the enable pin is located here, 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 and here on the board, we know how to align them, but you always want to double check. So I usually pick this up and I'll rotate it over and I'll find the enable pin, which is right over here, which means that I'm going to turn it over like so. I'm going to align it over the board, and then I'm going to apply a little bit of thumb pressure to place it in correctly. Now the same thing goes for this, but let's keep in mind that when we rotate this over, we're going to check to make sure where the enable pin is, which is right here. So I'm going to rotate that over and I'm going to install it like so. So the next thing I want to show you real quick is I want to install two steppers. So I'm going to take this stepper and I'm going to connect it like so to the X stepper port for the NEMA 17 stepper motor. Then I'm going to do the same for the other NEMA stepper motor. So I'm going to place it in this port for the Y axis. To program the SKR version 1.4, we need to connect the USB serial cable. So I'm going to place the big side of the connector in here, and then I'm going to take the small side of the connector and connect it to the computer, and you may hear a beep. Okay, to start with, as you can see, we have the default firmware from the last load that occurred on the board. I want to show you this so you can note the time and date. So I'm going to go over the manual real quick just so you can see how the jumpers are supposed to be aligned. Over here, we have the jumpers. And notice how there's three sets of pins and the two sets that we have jumped are like so. So next thing I'm going to do is I'm going to open up VS Code. Now VS Code has a plugin called Platform IO that has been loaded on this. If you haven't seen it loaded, you can check out the initial basics video. So what I'm going to do now is I'm going to go to the Marlin folder, then the source folder, then the core folder, then boards.h. Inside boards.h, I'm going to do a search on SKR. And what you have right here is board underscore big tree underscore SKR underscore V1 underscore 4. So we're going to copy that. Then we're going to close out of boards.h. And we're going to go and minimize these two folders and go to configuration.h. What I'm going to do is I'm going to search on motherboard. And I'm going to highlight board underscore ramps underscore 14 underscore EFB. I'm going to paste what we just copied. And then I'm going to scroll up and I'm going to change the serial port from 0 to negative 1. And then I'm going to do a search on the A4988. And as you can see down here, these are our steppers. Now, if you noticed, before each one of these, there's a hash mark that will comment out the line, meaning that it can't be used. In order to enable it, we need to remove the comment by backspacing. So we're going to do it for the X driver, the Y driver, the Z driver, and for good practice, we're going to do E0. Now, they're all enabled for the A4988. Now, we're not using two of them, which doesn't really matter, but we are using the X and the Y. Now, the A4988 does 1/16th of a step, whereas the DRV8825 does 1/32nd of a step. So what we need to do in order to change it is copy the DRV8825 and paste it over the A4988 in the X driver type. So we're going to paste it here. Then the next thing that we need to do is we need to scroll down and we need to check something here. Now, currently, as you can see right here, we have stepper units that they've decided on being 80 steps, and then we'll say 4,500 for X, Y, Z, and E0 being your first extruder. Now note, you can do many more extruders, but we'll talk about that in another video. But I want to show you, these are actual defaults that they assume you'll use for these numbers. But if we go over to like our web browser and we do a search on rep wrap calculator, and we go to, let's say, this link, which apparently is disabled and no longer works, so we'll go to the Prusa one. And as you can see down here, they have computations for how much filament. We're not interested in that. We are interested in the stepper motors. Now, these current stepper motors that we're using have a degree of step of 1.8 degrees, which means that it gives you 200 steps in a circle. In that case, that's what these NEMA 17 steppers are. But our stepper drivers may vary. So in this case, the driver micro stepping is 1/16th. This is what the default A4988 looks like. But if we have like 1/32nd of a step for a different stepper board, like the DRV8825, we'll click here. So the default value that you get that you can use inside your stepper configuration would be more like this for 400. So we know that for 1/32nd. For 1/16th of a step, it's probably going to be 200. But in the case that I'm showing you, I'm just showing you from the example Marlin file. So keep that in mind. And there are other variables in the equation, such as belt presets. There are different types of belts that you can use. So these will vary. And then there's a pitch inside the belt. So keep all these things in mind, also your pulleys. But we're going to go back to VS Code and we're going to use the values that we're given. So we have 80 for our X. We're going to use that for the A4988. And for the DRV8825, we're going to use 160. So the next thing that you want to do to set up your compilation is you have to go to platformio.ini. And right now, the default environment is set to Mega, ATmega 2560. This is not our chipset. Our chipset is the LPC1768 according to the manual. So we're going to highlight that and type LPC1768. Next, what we're going to do is we're going to go to the upload button down here, and this will compile or build and then upload our built software to our TF drive or SD card on our board. So I'm going to do that right now. This may take a few moments. Now that compilation has finished, we have a firmware.bin for our binary file. So what I'm going to do to load this is to remove the USB power and then reconnect the USB power. But before I do that, I want to confirm that the build actually occurred. So I'm going to go to VS Code. And as you can see, it said that it took 3 minutes to compile. But let's scroll up and look. So for our chipset being the LPC1768, it says successful. So we know that it says that the build took place successfully. So what we're going to do is we're going to go back to the USB drive. I'm going to remove the power for USB. Now I'm going to reconnect it. And note that the date and time have updated. Okay, off camera, I've connected the power supply with no power on the system, so there's nothing plugged in and the USB is not connected to the system. Now, if you've noticed right here, I put red marks on any place where there's positive power according to the schematic. Now, keep in mind, I'll explain later about the E0 and E1 steppers. For now, we're going to skip that. And for the heat bed as well. But for here, I have 12 volts connected and a ground. So what I'm going to do now is I'm going to energize the board. But the first thing I'm going to plug in is I'm going to plug in the USB for the big side, which I already have connected to my computer. So I'm going to plug that in, then I'm going to plug in the other side again, and you may hear a beep. Now I've done something wrong, so I'm going to power this down and remove this. Over here, you need to move the plug to the 12 volt power jumper setting. So this is going to run off your power supply now. Now I'm going to reconnect this. And I'm going to reconnect the USB to the computer. Now you don't hear a beep, obviously, because it's not running on USB power at the moment. Now I'm going to plug this into the wall. Now, as you can see, the board is now energized, so do not touch it because you'll damage, one, the board, and also I'm concerned that you might hurt yourself. So do not touch the board. As we already know, the firmware is updated. So I'm going to go over to our desktop. And on my computer, I've downloaded Print Run. So I'm going to open this up. And I'm going to go to Pronterface. In Pronterface, I'm going to click Connect. And as you can see over here, it said Connecting. Now it says Printer is now online. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to move the X stepper 100 steps. Now I'm going to move the Y stepper 100 steps. So if you like my tutorial, please press the like button and subscribe, and thank you for your time.